Yeah, that's the stuff. Like, I don't know if lowering my bitrate would help at all. I've got it at 2,000, which is what most people told me to, like, keep it at. So, I don't know. Sorry, I'm not a pro streamer. This is just something I do for fun. Let's look at my missions. Perform 2 triple matches. This is kind of hard to do on purpose. These things just kind of like... I find these missions just kind of happen. Like, they just... They occur when they occur. If you try to do them, like, they'll never happen. You just gotta let it. Just like, Never mind. I won't say anything else. Do you really stream at 400? Like, I'm not saying that to be like, oh my god, I can't believe you only stream at 400. Like, I'm asking, like, can a person stream at 400 and it'll... Because I've seen your stream and I know what it looks like, and I think that it looks okay. Alright, that's cool. I can appreciate that. And that's, Midnight Maniac is what what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to play some games that either have, like, that I feel got overlooked, or that just don't get streamed anymore, like they were popular at one point and now they're not. So either games that are, like, overlooked, or games that haven't been played in a long time. Oh wow, so I could probably lower my bitrate and still be okay. I might do that after this stream, like, for the future. I'm not gonna worry about it too much today. But I know I got some comments from people, like, the one guy that's in here all the time, Jeno. We're kinda, we know each other in the outside world a little bit, like, I say that, but... We used to game together in the same clan for, like, years. So, I'm pretty familiar with him, but, you know, he kept telling me, he's like, your computer's too old, it's not gonna be able to stream, you're not gonna be able to stream at any sort of quality. And then he came in the day I was playing Hand of Fate, and he's like, wow. So I can't believe that, one, that it looks this good, and two, that it's running this smooth. And then today I'm playing some, like, 8-bit games, like Barbarian, which is a mobile port, and then this game, which is also a mobile, I don't know if it's a direct port, but this game was also on mobile. And now I'm dropping frames like crazy. So, like I said, I don't know if it's just like a bad internet day, in which case there's nothing I can do about it. Like, at all. Or if it's something else. I'm just gonna keep playing and chatting with you guys. Yeah, those were pretty much his exact words, was I can't believe your toaster can run this. Kind of a running joke is that my computer's getting kind of old, and you know, she ain't what she used to be, that's for sure. But that's the thing, like, it's old hardware. Like, I think I built this computer like about 5 years ago, maybe a little less than that, but I've been able to run everything I want to play. Like, that's the thing, I haven't hit a wall yet that I can't, like, Hand of Fate is kind of borderline, and I don't know if it's because the game is too, you know, whatever, or if it's just poorly optimized. But there are a couple times where that game will chug a little bit, especially during the combat. But that's okay. But other than that, I mean, like I said, there's not a lot of games that, like, I want to play that I can't run. So, aside from the fact that I can't afford to upgrade my computer right now, I still don't really have a big need. It does everything I need it to do. And he was like, yeah, you're gonna need to upgrade if you're gonna plan on streaming. And I was like, I can't really afford it, so I just kinda let go of the idea of streaming for a while. And then... You know, I've been looking for work and not having a lot of luck, so I've just been kinda sitting around the house, like, depressed a lot, and I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna try it. If it works, it works. If it doesn't, it doesn't. So, I've just been streaming and stuff's been working out pretty well. I've been trying to make at least one improvement to the stream every day. I didn't really do anything today, so I don't know. But like, I got some proper like AFK screens, and I figured out how to set up a noise gate so that you guys don't hear my fans running all the time in my computer, because that was a pretty big problem when I was playing something the other day. It's not even that the game was like that intensive, it's just that I've been playing for a while and my computer was just kind of overheating a little bit, and so the fans were all going, and he's like, it's real loud when you're not talking and the game's not going. So I set up the noise gate, seems to work pretty well. I got it to not chop off my voice all the time. It's, you know, little things, just one day at a time. Like I said, I'm really just doing this for fun. I'm doing this for me and for you to just have a good time, check out some games. That's why I've been trying to like ask you guys a lot, what games you want to see, what do you want to see me play. I've been trying to play games that I've never played before, or maybe that I haven't played in a long time. I want to try to play games that you've never seen before. It's really, I want this channel to be more of like a showcase of games, instead of like me trying to be super pro MLG. That's never gonna happen. I'm just gonna spoil that for you right now. I'm bad at games, and I'm never gonna get better. Deal with it. Oh, Talif, is that the Pokemon that you have to catch for that area? In your Nuzlocke? Or what's going on? I hear you complaining about a Kakuna. Oh, I can't bring this down and drop it? I thought I could do that. But I always, like, whenever I'm in a stream and there's people in the stream being like, I want to be a streamer, what do you recommend? And the person is always like, play something that you're having fun with. Yeah, like, I could do that, like, have a game day where I play a game that I've never played before. So far this week, that's been, like, every day. I think I started with Hand of Fate, which I have played, so that doesn't count. And then I played Pokemon Sage, which was completely new to me. I mean, I've played Pokemon, obviously, but I never played Pokemon Sage, which was a custom game. I really enjoyed it. Then I played The Witcher board game. I played Oregon Trail, which I had practically never played before. Oregon, O-R-G-A-N, Trail. And then I played Barbarian yesterday and today, which I never played before. This game I've played, and I've played a lot. Yeah, Hand of Fate. I like that you like Hand of Fate, because I like it too, and I feel like it's gonna get overlooked by a lot of people because of, one, the price, and two, they just don't know what the game is. It's been miscategorized a lot. People see cards and they think, oh, collectible card game. It's not what it is. So yeah, I feel like a lot of people are gonna miss it. Which is a shame, because I believe it's a really good game at its core. I really like the choose-your-own-adventure stuff. Because it's a little unique, like there's not a ton of games out there like that. I know there's some, but, here we go. Triple match. Did I get two of them? I got two of them, I just got that achievement. Sorry, I'm trying to re-chat and play at the same time. This game is not very conducive. But I'm trying to keep up with what you guys are saying. I appreciate you guys being interactive and talking to me. But I don't want to ignore you and discourage good conversation, because I do really appreciate it. I lost. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I think that's what a lot of people do is when they build computers, some of the components are so expensive that once you get down to like the graphics card, which is like one of the only parts that you can chintz on, so people end up with like powerful PCs but with like a suboptimal graphics card. And so, you know, there's a lot of stuff you can't handle. Like, I'm running a GTX 460 right now, I think. Maybe a 470, I can't remember what number it is, but it's a 400 series. So I'm well behind the curve right now in terms of technology. But it's still going. There's a couple games where I have to turn some things down, but she's doing her best for me, and I appreciate it. Can I open any of these yet? I totally can. Not that one. What's this? Oh, okay, so this is actually really important, and I need to save some money up to get the armor. But yeah, I'm noticing, you know, I've been hanging out on Twitch for like 4 years now, and some people are really good. 465, I didn't know that was a thing. Yeah, but I've been hanging out on Twitch for a long time. Four in a row matches. That's kind of tough. And I've been in a lot of streams, and I've been in a lot of them where, like, the people are real good about managing chat. And I've been in some where they're real bad about it. And, I always thought it was just the person being, like, lazy or something. But now that I'm streaming, I've only got, what, 3 people in here right now? And I'm having problems keeping up. So I can only imagine, what people have to deal with when they've actually got a big channel. So now I have a lot more understanding for that, I think. Where, like, I'm not gonna get mad if everything I say isn't acknowledged personally. I never was that way, but now I understand it a lot more intimately, I think. Try to keep using these. I keep forgetting I have these items. Try to remember to use them from time to time. Don't tilt. Don't tilt. You're tilting. I tilted. Yeah, I noticed as soon as I said that I think the game set me up for it, maybe, because I got like 4 immediately. I didn't know if it was going to count that one because I did 2 fours on the same move, and I didn't know if it would count, but apparently it did. So, because that's why I was kind of searching around. I'm like, I need a 4th 4 because I don't think that counted. Because it doesn't show you until the end of the match if it counted. Anyway, it's kind of funny. But yeah. I like this game. This game's kind of fun. I used to play this a lot when I was living at my old apartment. Because my roommate and I, like, I don't want to say we didn't get along, but, like, there came a point in time where he just never wanted to he kind of clammed up and he didn't want to talk to me anymore. But she was dealing with some stuff, I get it. Shoot, okay. Kind of stuck there. But yeah, so it was just like a lot of time I was just like, well, I guess I'll just go to my room and play video games. And my internet there was horrible. Like super bad. It was hard enough to watch Twitch. Like, I had to watch everything on either medium or low. So, playing games on the internet was out of the question. So I played a lot of single-player stuff at that point in my life. And this game, like, I was kind of hooked on it for about a week. It was right about the time... I remember it was right about the time the Starbomb album came out. Because I would play this game while listening to the album. Because I'm mature, and I like highbrow music and comedy. Oh my goodness, so many locks! Let's just open it. Oh, it killed me. Yeah, Endymaniac, I've been there. Done that. I won't mention any names, Man vs. Game. No, I'm not trying to say anything bad about him. I love the guy. He's a great guy. His stream has definitely changed. But he's doing his thing, and he's being successful at it, and I'm happy for him. But when I first started on JTV, I remember being in Man vs. Game's channel when there was like maybe like 20 to 25 people. When he was playing like New Super Mario Bros. Or something like that, and there was just a few of us in chat, so everything we said, he's like, oh man, and he'd like respond to every single thing that anybody said, and it was a real cool, like, but that was back when JTV was small, and all the communities were small, but yeah, like I said, he's doing real good, and I'm happy for him. Definitely changed, I don't hang out there as much as I used to, but it's nothing personal. Yeah, I'm moderating a couple chats, but they're mostly just like people who were like, oh, this guy's cool, I'm gonna mod him. Like one guy gave me a mod because I gave away a game in his chat one time. One of them is Geno, and I think it's because I'm the only one who goes to his channel. Anyway, let me look at these. I want to see if I want to buy one of these. 5% crit chance is pretty good. I'm going to get all these eventually, but I just want to see if there's one I want to prioritize. Chance past 5, I don't do this that often. This is good. So let's upgrade our armor like I said I wanted to. So this makes it so that we don't get knocked back as far, and that enemies can't attack as often. Kill a monster using only magical orbs. Oh, I did that already. 10 double matches. A lot of these, like I said, are just things that are just gonna happen kind of naturally. Can't force it, you just gotta do it. Oh, it wasn't enough. I need 3. So I'm gonna use... It's basically every time I get an item that isn't a magical orb, I'm just gonna waste it, basically. So that I can get 3 magical orbs, so that I can get that, thingamajigger. See you guys talking over there, and I wanna look. I wanna look. Gotta focus. Focus. Ah! Balls. Yes, the other thing too is like, you pick mods because they're people that are always in your channel, and then like people's lives change, and I get that, and then it's like they're never there, and then you gotta pick new mods, and then like the old people come back, and then all of a sudden it's like your whole channel is mods. And it's like, moderator doesn't mean anything anymore. But at that point, it's usually like your channel is full of people you trust anyway. And so you're not going to have a lot of troublemakers. So it's not that bad. Oh, I got that? I didn't think I got that. Anyway. Excuse me. It's not that big of a deal, but... As of right now, since my chat's so small, I'm just going to moderate it myself. Just because I don't feel like... I don't know. I feel like everybody who's always in here is like a decent human being. And, I would just end up modding everybody, and it would just be to the point where being moderator was just more of a status symbol. And I don't really care. Need an item of food just before timeout. I hate it when I get goals for things that like I've either done already, like in the past, or like literally just did. Cause I've done that one in the past. I tried to eat the food right before I got hit, and I ended up being too late anyway, and I still died. Anytime I get a huge chain like that, don't for one second think that it's because I'm good at this game. I'm just moving things. Like, all over the place. And hoping good stuff happens. In fact, just as a general rule of thumb, just assume I'm not good at any game that I play. Aw. Dang it. I should have used the bread, and I would have got the just-in-time thing. Yeah, Talif, I usually set, like, when I play Nuzlocke, I kind of set some, like, personal ground rules that just make the run more fun for me. Like, I don't catch anything that I've already caught. And if I kill something on accident, I'll usually let myself try again in the area. But, like, if I just kill it because I don't want it, then that's it. And sometimes if my party starts getting, like, really heavily, like, tilted in, like, one specific type, sometimes I'll make an executive decision and just be like, hey, I'm gonna catch something else. I don't need 7 water types. Alright, I got 1 magical orb. So I'm gonna use that key scroll, but I've already got so many keys on the screen right now. I don't want to use it, because then my screen's gonna be all keys, and if I come up against an enemy, I'm not gonna be able to kill it. Alright, Talif, do what you gotta do, man. Oh, did that count? Did I get it? Got it. Let's see. I can afford anything. Smoked steel weapons. So I'm at the point where I need to upgrade. Imagine 26 backpacks should be Z. I'm stuck. Here we go. Oh, jeez. Yeah, this game's fun. Like, it takes, like, the kind of match 3, which I feel is, like, severely overdone. And it makes it fun, again. Like, by adding RPG elements and goals and unlocks and all that stuff, like, it makes me want to keep playing. And I think that's the problem with a lot of match 3s, is, like, it's all about score. It's like, oh, get a high score, impress your friends. I'm like, oh, well, I don't have any, so... This is dumb. Yeah. But anyway, yeah, this game really... really takes an old, stale formula and breathes new life into it. And the music is good. Like, the graphics are simplistic, but they work. And I just like having, like, kind of like the overarching RPG progression, so it feels like what I'm doing in each game matters a little bit, and I can do certain games where, like, I try to focus on, like, leveling, like, collecting supplies, and others where, like, I focus more on, you know, doing the objectives, you know, fun game. What else can I say? Oh, so there's a dragon up here, which I think is kind of like the area boss. I'm probably about to die. Because they hit really hard, and they knock you back really far every time they hit you. So, yeah, I'm not quite there yet in terms of Oh, I got this one finally. Sneaky stab. Yeah, I'm not quite there yet, though, in terms of, like, my power to be able to take on the dragon yet. But that's, you know, part of the game. Just gotta level up a little bit at a time. You get these abilities. You level up your armor and your weapons. I need more stuff for that. Upgrade this. Does that unlock anything new for me? It does, but it's all expensive. Weak iron jerkin. Yeah, you know, I totally agree with that statement. Like, it seems like an easy cop-out thing to do, where I feel like there's a lot of games out there, it's like, oh, check out this racing game with RPG elements. It is such an easy way to sucker me into playing it. And if it's done well, if it's done well, it's good, but I feel like a lot of times, like, RPG elements are just a way for them to say, like, gated gameplay, where it's like, you need to play 100 levels before I let you play this next level. And there's really no, like, role-playing. It's just like, I'm playing the role of some guy who got suckered into playing this game 100 times. But this one's a little different. Like, you know, you feel like you're getting better. You're like, oh, my attacks do more damage. I'm gathering more resources. I'm getting more time bonuses. I'm getting more items out of chests. You know? I need to remember to use these so that I can get the golden orbs. Or the magic orbs. Sometimes, so what I just did there, part of it was like me trying to just waste that item, but sometimes it's actually really good to use those scrolls, even if you like, if you need to attack something, sometimes it's good to use a key scroll, and it's because it allows you to get a lot of fast and easy matches, which can, one, create combos, and two, it'll put a lot more of, crests you need on the board. So sometimes it's a perfect way to get yourself unstuck, is to just pop one of those scrolls, even if it's not for the resource that you need. It's kind of an advanced level strategy, so I'm surprised that I'm using it. But yeah. Alright. Let's get some more stuff unlocked. Got a lot of wooden stone, but there's no real point in, like, upgrading these things right now because I, tell me what level I am. There's no real point in upgrading them yet just because I don't even have the money to buy the upgrades. This is kind of pointless. Give my shield if I can. Yeah, I haven't done much with this. Upgrading your shields is really important. There we go, that's the one I need. So that lets me carry up to 19 shield crests that I can store up. And basically, like, when a big monster attacks you, it won't, or when small monsters attack you, it'll take away from those shields instead of taking away from your time. So upgrading your shield is important. Oh, I almost killed that in one hit. Which is my my new objective. And yes, I did upgrade my base. Sorry, I saw that you said that, and I meant to say something, and then I got sidetracked. Sorry. I did upgrade my base. At least some parts of it. Like I said, there's no real rush, because if you don't have the money to buy new upgrades anyway, you're basically just, I mean, you're upgrading it for the future, but you're not at an advantage over waiting until you need the upgrade. Got stuck. Basically, I need to fight one of those blue things, and I need to get a 5 sword attack, and I would be like money in the bank. Shoddy, what you drink? Yeah, I've got orbs, but I'm trying to save them because I have a quest right now to kill a monster using only orbs, and at this point in time, with how much damage they do, I'm gonna need all 3 to kill something. So I'm trying to save them. You know, I'm kind of putting the overall goal ahead of like surviving this individual run. Trying to kind of waste items that aren't magical orbs to make room for when I pick up a magical orb, because I only have 3 inventory spots right now. This one I can't use. As you can see, it's covered in cobwebs. But if I pick up or get a chest that has a magical orb... Oh, dang it. I threw that too early. And my inventory's full, it just drops on the ground. You know, it might be enough, but I think this game has, like, elemental types. So if I had the right colored orb, and it, I was fighting a monster that was weak against that color, I could probably do it. But as it is right now, I think I need 3. I think this is my favorite track in the game. I don't know why. This music just gets me going. I'm gonna die at this dragon anyway. Alright. I got that one at least. I'm just gonna go on. I really wanna complete this stupid kill monster with an orb. Yeah, and I can get really close to killing these things in one hit if I match 4. So I either need to upgrade my weapon or match 5. If I want to get that kill an enemy in one hit. Or get a critical, which I can't really control. That'll just happen if it happens. Thank you. Yeah, getting a match 5 is just like kind of luck of the draw. Oh, I got 3 orbs now, so next time I come up against an enemy, I can orb it to death. Here we go. Oh, it did work in 2. Oh, dang it. Such an idiot. I wasted it. I think that maybe that fire elemental might have been weak to that element. Because I know before I tried to kill a fire elemental with 2 and it didn't work. So I assumed I needed 3, but I think they were red orbs, which would make sense that a red fire would be strong against red element. That's pretty good though. Alright, so we got some money. Yeah, and that's, yeah, some of the enemies are weak to magic, some are weak to sword. This also would have helped if I would have just bought this upgrade. This is pretty good. I'm gonna get some of these ones though, some of these lower level ones, because I can get 2. That's a good one. And that's a good one. That's cool. I can't. I don't have enough money. Expensive. Oh, and that's right, that only upgrades crit chance. That was waste. Waste. Alright, we'll just save up for a bit. Kill 7 monsters. I think I can do that. I think I have done that. I've done that several times, actually. Here's match 5. Heck. Oh no. My dude's booking it though. Seems like I'm getting further ahead of the death line. It's always good. There we go. Only stopped at 5. 6 chance, good though. Oh, the tree ants! Oh, the tree ants are OP! The tip told me! Oh. Pretty good, though. I got the survivor and the monster bash. Got a lot of gold. Yeah, this game is actually kind of intense. That's why I get kind of quiet. I'm just like, sitting here like, oh man, am I gonna win? Yeah, that's one thing I hate about using mobile chat is autocorrect. Alright, so I'm able to get the next level up if I can get over 3800, which I have, like, clearly done. It should just give it to me. And then I can unlock the last room in my little cave. Little man cave here. Oh, I wanna... I didn't want to move that because I had a... Dang it. I had a match 5 set up. That do. Didn't do anything. What do you mean play us out? There's no words on it. All this food I got, though. Add food money over here. Okay. Stuck. I am stuck. Eat the food. Here we go. Key though. Give me a key. Keys, please. Oh, I'm not gonna get out of this alive. One's over. It's all over with the crying. Oh, and I didn't even get the high score that I needed. Desperately needed. Yeah. Eat it. Oh, you got pizza? I want pizza. I think I have some leftover pizza, which is like not the same as like new pizza. New pizza's so much better. It's still pretty good though, I guess. Hand of fate. Like, last time I played, I think I did pretty good on, like, I was so... It was so different than the run against the Skeleton King where I had one health. I had, like, a ton of health, I had plenty of food, I had good items, like... That game just all came together for me. Whereas, like, the one where I was fighting against the King of Skulls was just like, hey, we're just gonna totally ruin your game. And then you're gonna have to win anyway. Enjoy. I got a gift card, that's pretty sweet. Wish I had a gift card. Make me jealous over here of every part of your life. Pizza, gift cards, and people that give you gift cards, and people that talk to you. Just kidding. Not really. Too alone. And I'm comboing like crazy over here. Oh, I lost. They're fighting. Alright, well, I got the rank up. Having friends is overrated. piss me off all the time. Internet friends are the best because, like, if you really, really, like, get mad or, like, something, the point where you think you're gonna say something stupid, you just leave. You just leave the situation and then be like, oh, you know what? My internet went out. I'm sorry. Okay, so this is the Alchemist Shop. Sorry, I just kind of spaced out for a second there. And these give you, like, different potions for different ranks that you achieve. So this one, you get 0 wood and stone. But then you get 20% of what you would have got as gold. So, this is more for late game once you've already upgraded all your buildings and you don't need wood and stone anymore. And this is, 0 experience, but you get more wooden stone. This one, I think I used to use this, because you get minus 25% damage, but plus 25% critical chance. Which, once you get your weapon upgraded to a decent level, adding 25% crit chance on it can give you, like, 50% crit, so it's kind of worth it. And then this one, I used to use this until, like, I started getting mad because I would lose all the time because I couldn't unlock the stupid chest. But anyway, I think you can activate more than one. Yeah, so you can activate and deactivate these at will. So if there's, like, ever a time where you're trying to get, like, a specific resource, you can activate a potion for it. You know, whatever. But, I'm about to hit the 4-hour mark, so I'm gonna take a quick fiver, just get up and stretch, and, go to the bathroom, grab a snack maybe, I'm getting a little peckish, but then we'll be back and I'll play a little bit more of this, or whatever you guys, if you guys are tired of this and you wanna see something else, let me know, I'll play something else. Also, welcome back, Talif, just in time to watch my break screen. But yeah, I'll be right back. Jenna, you shut your mouth. No. Midnight. He's saying that the reason my XCOM, the reason my Xbox 360 was banned was because I turned on my webcam and I was so ugly that it triggered someone and they reported me and Microsoft banned it. That is not true. But yeah, the console was banned because, I took it to a friend's house one time and then paid him $20 or $25, maybe it was $50. I paid him a certain amount of money to, like, just make sure my Xbox was doing okay and had the latest, you know, updates to the firmware. And then all of a sudden my Xbox started playing games on burned discs. And I don't know how it happened. It was just really weird. I just took it in for, like, a checkup and all of a sudden it's playing, like, games on discs that are, like, blank and stuff. And then one day, Xbox found out that people were, like, that they were having this problem with their Xboxes playing burned discs. And so they released this, like, worldwide patch to, like, detect if your firmware was, you know, updated to this version that was, like, playing these rogue discs. And they couldn't figure out how to undo it, so they just banned everybody. So that's what happened. And if anyone says otherwise, they are a dirty liar. Yeah. Bite me. Okay, so no one said anything. I'm gonna keep playing this game till someone says something. You want to see something else, all you gotta do is say so. And I'll play it. But until then, I guess I'll just, let's play this. Upgrade my weapon sharpness until no one ever. Oh, I meant to. Let's go. I do. Okay. So that's the only suggestion I have right now is Hand of Fate, which I'm fine with. I'll go back to it. Not sure how my stream will handle it today with the issues I've been having, but. Willing to at least try it. Yeah, I was just smithing with some stuff. No big deal. I knew it was up. I knew it. Shut up. Alright, so I'll do at least one more run of this. If something got something they're dying to see, let me know. If not, I'll, I guess I can hop off here and play some Hand of Fate for a little bit. I'm fine with that, because I haven't played it since, like, Monday or Tuesday. And I did kind of want to, you know, my goal is to finish it. I'd like to finish it. Oh my goodness, so many chests! I actually wanted to fight an enemy because I had a, 4 swords lined up. And I wanted the thing for killing the enemy in one hit. Alright, so this guy is practically immune to magic. It's true, he's gonna, you know, as soon as I go back there, he's gonna make some smart aleck comment. Like, oh, I thought you were a giant wuss and weren't gonna come back. So I gave away all your cards to someone who's a real man. And be like, alright. Yes. That's how you really feel about me. And the game's gonna make me start from the beginning. That's one thing I will say, like, Steam Cloud, God bless you, man, because there are a lot of games that, that I would really be devastated if I had to start over from the beginning, and Hand of Fate is one of them, and, like I said, I recently had to reformat my computer because of something that I don't want to talk about, oh, I died, yeah, so I had to reformat because it's something that, we're not gonna go into. so that's why this game, I had to start from the beginning. Because, I lost my save data. Actually, I'm not gonna spend any experience, I'm gonna save it for this stuff, but... yeah, so I'll go ahead and we'll switch a Rooney. Nope. I hate that. I hate when games are like, let me make the exit button, like, really cryptic and hard to find. So I got some, trading cards. I just want to look at them real quick. Apparently, like, trading cards got added for a lot of games after I played them. It's really funny, because the trading cards for this game are, like, the art for the enemies and stuff is, like, really realistic. And in the game, they're all, like, pixelated little munchkins. Anyway, yeah, so I got some trading cards for that.